because of what is at stake when we consider our health and the environment, our planet Earth, and the destruction that we are causing, and also of the process that needs to be done in order for you to consume that burger or drink your milk, there is no way, with seeing all the evidence, there is no way any justifications can be made when we consider eating meat. Nope. You know, we've all either said or heard someone justify whether they're saying, well, other animals eat animals, or we have canine teeth, so that means we're carnivores. Or the most talked about, I need to eat meat in order to get my protein, where else am I going to get it? Or, it just tastes that damn good. Man, I can never give this stuff up. No matter what the justification is, and in no way am I even being biased, you can counteract any statement made that leads someone to believe that in this day and age, animals and eating animals is very necessary, or that eating animals makes sense. I can say that because that is my own opinion. So one argument people try to use to justify eating animals is that because we have canine teeth, we are designed to eat meat. But actually, nearly all mammals have canine teeth. And even herbivores, such as gorillas, hippos, have the largest canine teeth in the world. And they eat plants. So, throw that justification out the window. Okay, so if we're not supposed to eat animals, well then what about other animals eating animals? Well, to counteract that, animals in the wild who eat other animals are solely going against eating on their survival instincts. We have no survival instinct to literally go and attack, pounce on an animal, and eat it. If we did, then we would have no problem eating meat raw. And if we did, then if you gave a little baby an apple or a rabbit and told it to eat one and play with the other, they might have a harder time trying to decide what to eat. And even another way we can counteract that argument is that all animals in the wild, the prey has a chance of survival. The way that we kill animals now, we don't give the animals any chance of surviving. They are literally born and bred for our own taste. They have no option to live or not. Hey, if you really want to eat meat, go outside, go pounce on an animal, bite into it with your mouth, and eat it raw like a true carnivore. I believe, like humans, all animals are sacred, and other beings are not our food. That there is another opinion of mine. Just an opinion. Well now, let's get into the most famous conversation. Protein. I need to eat meat to get my protein. Well, let's get this straight. First, there's a reason why the government spends $557 million to promote the meat and dairy industries, but only $51 million to promote vegetables and fruits. We don't need near as much protein than that is recommended. The amount of protein that we really do need compared to what we've been taught and led to believe are completely different numbers. Those of which who have lied about the amount of protein that we need are either lobbyists for the meat and dairy industries, or they have some sort of partnerships or investments within the meat and dairy industries. Now, the American Dietetic Association recommends 0.8 grams of protein per kilogram. Now, originally, one of the champions of protein, a German scientist by the name of Karl Voigt, found founded that man needed only 48.5 grams of protein per day. But nothing less, he recommended a whopping 118 grams per day because of the cultural bias at the time. Protein equaled meat, and everyone aspired to have meat on his or her table, just as we aspired to have bigger houses and faster cars. Voigt figured you can't get too much of a good thing. Boy, was he wrong. Then when he became a director of the USDA, he recommended even more, 125 grams of protein. And now, which not many people even know about because we go by the statistics, which aren't even statistics, but the beliefs of old scientists like Carl Voigt, only about 55 grams per day is recommended. This is the China Study. It's the best book you can ever read, the most informational, informative piece of artwork you could ever read. This is a, you know, startling implications for the diet, weight loss, and longer term health. This is all about the connection between diet and disease, and it's the most comprehensive study that has ever been conducted, over 35 years long. Now, with all the saturated fats and cholesterol that comes with eating animals, and especially when you are still believing about the amount of protein that you might have to eat, eating animal protein is directly linked to cancer growth and basically all heart diseases and illnesses that you can even think of. Now, with plant protein, you can eat as much as you want, and no cancer growth or illnesses will occur whatsoever. Now, that is not my opinion. I am not making that up. That is not my belief. That is fact. Look into it. So when it comes to protein, we've been lied to about all sorts of things. The amount that we need, the quality of animal protein versus plant protein, and we're never even taught to believe the fact that animal protein, especially overconsumption, rates the growth of cancer cells. And the last justification is that it just tastes so good. This is the most selfish statement one can make. It's also an understandable statement, because when one says, I just can't give up meat, man, I'm like addicted. Well, of course you can't give it up. Just like a crackhead will say, I can't give it up. I can't give up crack. They're dependent on the meat, because for a lot of people, meat really is an addiction. You know what? It's okay. I know I cause pain, suffering, and murder to living beings because I like the taste. Are you okay, dude? Most people wouldn't even really enjoy the taste of steak without putting spices onto it. Because I like the taste of meat, it's okay to justify the incarceration, the imprisonment, forced rape, the pain, the torture, and suffering, and essentially, the mass murder, the mass destruction of families, living beings who feel, breathe, eat, sleep just like you and I. Man, there's no justification for that. Because of a taste buds. Just so unnecessary. I don't look down upon on anyone. I don't hate anyone, for that matter. Because to put hate onto someone really just shows what's going on the inside of you. You put hate onto somebody, you have hate in your heart somewhere. You have hate deep down somewhere. So, you know, people have different beliefs, and people try to justify eating animals. But there's a difference. Some people just don't really know how wrong it is, because they haven't, you know, come across or really thought about it that much. They haven't watched videos or documentaries like Earthlings, and they don't really know what's going on, what's happening to the animals. They never really thought about it. But other people, they know all about it, and they justify because, well, either A, they have an addiction to meat and they really don't want to give it up, for two, they know what's wrong, but hell, they don't care. They don't care that much to give it up. They're selfish. But, you know, that's all I gotta say. He's smiling. I'm just trying to spread the awareness. I'm just trying to get people thinking if they haven't already. Just trying to uplift other people's lives like it has for me. Like this lifestyle has given me. And it's given me so much joy and awareness and different, you know, outlook on life and different attitudes towards life. And I would not be the person I am today if I didn't come across veganism, and not even just that title. Throw that title out the window. It's following through with your true morals, your true compassionate values, and really showing that you care and not being selfish, and to really show love to all beings on this earth, and really take back my own health, because I know that I am not gonna age like most people do, because a big part of our aging and our crippling and our diseases and our illnesses have to do with animal consumption. You gotta eat the food that nature provides you, has all the vitamins and minerals and nutrients that you need, because we are herbivores. We are. So, hope y'all enjoy. Coming back at you with another video. Peace. I'm out.